Hello students, back to the class. So the last classes we have discussed about the essential element of state. Second point, territory. So we have discussed territory includes land, water, sea, spaces, okay, etc. Now in this topic we will study about government. Government is the third important element of the state. So we will discuss about government, how far this element is useful, okay, and important. Now see, already we know essential element government, which is the essential element of state. So children, I already said you before, okay, we have without government, okay, without government, if they have population, if they have state, if they have territory, we cannot population our territory. Without government we can't call any particular area as a state, territorial unit as a state. If without government there is no state, and without state there is no government. States and government are interrelated as well as interdependent to each other. Now we will discuss about government. In this government we will discuss about what are the important functions of government, why government is important in the state. So already we discussed that government is very very important in the state. So we have to discuss that why the government is very very important for the state. What is the reason? What are the role played by the government in state? Government perform different type of functions. Okay, without government we know that state cannot function or state cannot survive. Government will perform different type of functions. So in this point we will discuss that what are the important functions the government will perform, etc. Okay, first one. So here we can find that first the government will try to regulate. The government will regulate the policies. First one, policies. So first the government will regulate the rules and regulations. The government will regulate the policies, plans, etc. Regulating is very very important. Running, okay, so regulating the administration, running the administration is very very important. That comes under the control of only government. Government will regulate the plans, government will regulate the policies, government will regulate the administrations, etc. Regulating. So second thing, government will control human activities. Human involve different type of activities. What are the main activities? For example, human is mainly involving in industries. Trade. Transport. Health. Tourism. So human beings are in human activities. This is because human beings are involving in different activities. In the sense, involvement is there. Some human beings are involvement in primary sectors. They are involving in agricultural activity. Some are involving in industrial activity. Some are involving in hospitality. Some are involving in hotel trades, restaurants, transport facilities. So like that, if you see that human beings are involvement is there in different types of activities. Okay, so government will try to regulate the human activities. Second important thing is government will control these human activities. Controlling is very very important. Of course the involvement is human beings. Human beings are involving in different type of activities. If human beings are not involving in activities, they cannot survive. If they wanted to survive, then their involvement is very very important. So nowadays if you see that human beings are depending on different sectors. Most of the time if you see service sectors, most of the people at present are mainly depends on service sectors, like for example tourism, health, transport facilities, trade. So all the most of the human involvement is there in the sectors. To earn the livelihood, human beings are involving in different types of activities, work. Okay, so that is one point. So what government will do? Government will control all these activities. Every activities like industries, trade, tourism, road, transport facilities, hospitality, etc. Whatever the activities are there, everything will be under the control of government. So government will control the activities and human beings are involving in these activities. So if there is no controlling of these activities, then what happen? It will get problem. The activities might get problems. So that's why human beings involvement in the activities, it's very important that government should control the activities. Controlling is very very important. Checking, controlling, regulating, this is nothing but these are the works of government only. So whatever the activities the human beings are involving, so government, what they will do, they will try to regulate these activities. How the government will regulate? By making some policies, by making them to develop. So government, what they do, they will try to develop these activities. So this is important. Next one, they will make the human beings, this is a responsibility of government, they will enable them to live harmony, peacefully. So it is very, very important function of government. So government should see that wherever the society, where the people are living, already we have discussed in the last class, what we have discussed, territory. Territories are involving some powerful factors, indispensable factor. What is the powerful factor? Territories make the people to live together, and living together can cause a feeling which is unity. Unity will develop. So territory can develop a strong sense of unity among the people. So normally when the people are living together, different type of problems also will come. Advantage is this, every point has certain effect and defect, advantage as well as disadvantages. So when the people are living together, at one side unity will develop, at the same time disturbances also will come. So it's a responsibility of government that whenever the people are living in any society, they should live peacefully and harmony. Okay, most of the areas we can find, whenever the population will be more, problem also will affect more. Okay, whenever the population will be more, problems also will appear there. So it's a responsibility of government to see that wherever the people are living, either territory, when the people are living in state, society, city, so they should live with harmony. It's a responsibility. If there is any misunderstanding between the two groups, or if there is any problem which was arises, then it's a responsibility of government that they should solve the problem, because government is a head. Who will try to solve the problems? Head only. Who is the head of the country? He will try to solve the problems. In the ancient time, whenever the problems will arises, kings used to solve the problem. But now, in the modern form of government, the responsibility was given to government. In the modern form of society, the responsibility is given to government. So it's a responsibility of government that they should maintain peace and harmony. Okay, so government can use the administrative force, like police force. They can use this administrative force and they can control and they can maintain their harmony, peaceful relations. Okay, on the other hand, now I'll go forward here. This is one point. At the same time, the government, it's a responsibility of government. What is the responsibility of government? It's a responsibility of government to solve the common problems. There are many problems. Society normally, when the people are living sometime, wants have unlimited. According to the main political science, human beings have unlimited wants. Okay, sometime we can find human beings and common peoples have many problems. And whatever the problems will be there, it's a responsibility of government to solve the problem. Food, clothing, shelter. So government have to see that whatever the basic needs are there, basic needs. Normally when we are learning about basic needs, okay, what are the basic needs? Like we can find food, clothing. Okay. So food, clothing, we can find shelter, medical facilities. So all these facilities the government should be able to solve. Whatever the common problems are there, whatever the facilities are there, it is a responsibility of government to provide all these facilities. So here, to solve the common problems. Okay, normal problems, whatever the problems which appears in the society, what are the common problems? The problems which are regarding transport problems, the problems which are regarding jobs, employment problem. Okay, nowadays employment problem is becoming a common problem. Transport problems, schools problems, education problems, health sectors, particularly normally when we are talking about health facility, health sectors, health issues are more common. So health issues are more common in the modern state. So what government should do? Whatever the basic facilities are there, so it's a responsibility of government to provide all these facilities to the people. They should solve the problem of the people. Okay, people have many wants, at the same time problems also is more. So it's a responsibility of government to solve the problems. And how to solve the problem? The government should solve the problems energetically, and government should solve the problem effectively. Effectively the government should solve the problems. In the sense, whenever the problems will come, sometime what will happen? It will take a lot of time to solve the problems. Okay, so problems to react upon that problem, it will take a long period of time. So nowadays, if you can find some government organizations and government machineries are there. Now, some government machineries, a certain extent, they will solve the problem quickly. But there are some machineries, it will take some time. So even though the government, if they wanted to, if the problems are being highlighted, the government should solve the problem energetically, and the government should solve the problem effectively. Effectively in the sense, whenever they are solving a problem, that type of problem again should not come. Okay? So this is the responsibility of government. So government should be very clear in these issues. Next one, if you see that for functioning of state, if you wanted to function the state, it's very important that the role of government is important. Okay, so government role is very important for functioning the states. If government is there, if state is there, then to function the states, the role of government is very, very important. Without government, the state cannot function. Okay, so for functioning state, the role of government is very, very important. Okay, so population is important, territory important, population, territory, government, these are considered as one of the important elements for state. Next one, government is also called as an agency of state. In most of the point, if you see, government is an agency of the state. All the state administrations, all the states of administration work will be under the control of government. So that is called as an agency of state. Okay, so this is one point. Next one, if you see, government, without government, nowadays we can find, now okay, this point we will go forward. Now come to the point here. So it's a responsibility of government. First one, they should maintain the laws and order. Okay, in most of the states, whenever the laws and, as soon as when population will be more, problems also will be more, I say it to you. So being a modern state, it's a responsibility of government to maintain the laws and order very strictly. The places where the rules and regulations and laws and orders are strict, there we can find the problems are very less. And laws and order should be implemented effectively. Okay, in most of the cases when the laws and orders are implemented, that should be effectively planned. So it's a responsibility of government that whenever the government is maintaining the laws and order, it should be done effectively. So laws and order should be made effectively and it should be properly implemented, laws and order. And next one is, we know that not in all the cases, in most of the cases what will happen in the modern states, most of the person will follow the rules, but not all the people are following rules. Some people will unfollow or sometime they will break the law. Okay, that's why the government have set up mechanism. Okay, government have stated some machineries. Okay, so government, what they have set up, they have set up some machinery. So whenever the government faces any problem, okay, government have set up machineries to maintain the laws and order. Okay. So government have set up some machineries, mechanism, like they have set up some administrative unit, okay, to solve the problems. So whenever the person is not following the law, they should get punishments. So whenever any person who are breaking the law, who are not following the law, so what they should do, the government should punish them strictly. So again, the next time nobody will break the law. So this is also one point. So it's a role of government only. So government should maintain the laws and order in a proper way. If anybody will follow the law, okay, so appreciation must be done. If anybody is not following the law, then they should be given punishments severely and strictly. So next time nobody should disobey the laws. Everybody should obey the law. Already we have discussed that in every democratic country, when all the people are equal in front of law, when we have rule of law already. You know that what is rule of law? Okay, we have discussed what is called rule of law. So rule of law is nothing but when all the people are equal in front of law, that is called as rule of law. So everybody, when they are equal in front of law, then everybody have to follow the law, everybody have to obey the law. Okay, when people are not obeying the law, then what the government mechanism should do? They should force, they should punish them strictly to for the law, law breakers who are breaking the law. For them the punishment must be given very strictly. That is one. Next one, at the same time the responsibility of the government. What is the last responsibility of government? At the same time the government responsibility is to promote welfare activities. Okay, welfare activities like it's a response, construction of hospitals, okay, construction of tourism, okay, construction of roads, schools, colleges, okay, different type of health institutions, okay, different type of technological colleges at a free of cost. So it's a responsibility of government to promote the welfare, general welfare. India is a welfare state. Okay, welfare state means whenever the government is uplifting the people, to uplift the people when the government is trying, so that state will be called as welfare state. Nowadays in the modern state, all the states are welfare states. Almost all the states will try to uplift the people. India is also a welfare state. In such conditions, who will promote the welfare activities? Government only. If there is no government, then nobody will be there to promote the welfare activities. Nobody is there to promote the state level. So it's a responsibility of government to develop these types of welfare activities. Helping, we can find the setting up of schools for the people. Okay, setting up of all the facilities. By constructing schools, they should provide different type of facilities. And next one is, they should provide some employment opportunities. They should develop some industrial activities. Okay, they should open some service activities and service institution. So that service institution should provide huge amount of employment for the people. That is also one type of welfare activity. Okay, so providing them free scholarship for the students. So whoever the people who are belongs to the middle class also, low class also, they should promote scholarship facilities. Scholarship facilities should be given to almost all the children who are economically as well as backward children. So that type of scheme should be implemented. So that type of facility should be implemented. So that comes under the category of general welfare. So that's why we'll say that government is just like a tool. Okay, this is a very important tool to develop the state. Okay, without government the state cannot able to develop. Okay, and that's why it is very important that it will say that government is very important for state. So government is also called as an agency. And at last, if you see that government is not only necessary but also compulsorily, it is very very important. They should be compulsorily a government. Okay, government is not only a necessary but also the rule of government is quite compulsory. Okay, without government we can't do anything else. So we have discussed in this topic many things, even though for implementing the policies, okay, for developing the countries, for controlling the laws and order, and for regulating the administration, first one regulation will come. For regulating the administration, for controlling all the activities, and then development, for developing all the sectors, for developing the sectors and for developing the human activities. Involvement of government is very very important. At the same time, when the government is controlling the laws and order, they should see that all the people should obey the laws. If anybody are breaking the law, they should be punished severely, and the punishment should be given strictly. So government should make them the people to live harmony and peacefully. Okay, they should not create any problems. So it's a responsibility of government that when the people are living in the society, they should live with harmony as well as peaceful. And whenever the problems will come, the government should solve the common problems of the people, like water problem, medical problem, health problem, okay, education problem. These are the common problems. So government should solve all these common problems, and government should solve these problems, should act energetically and effectively. This is one point. Suddenly he should act. Whenever the problems will come, the government should act suddenly. The government should react suddenly. Then the problems will solve. If the problems is going to be increases, then it will take a lot of time. So whenever the government is solving the problem, the government should act energetically and effectively. Then the problems can be able to solve quickly. So these are the important functions of government we have seen. Okay, government is just like a important tools to develop the states. So That's why we'll say that without government there is no state, and without state there will be no government. So both are interrelated and both are interdependent to each other. Okay, so state have to depend upon government for development, and government also have to depend upon state. So at last, population, okay, territory and government, which is the third element, these are the very important element of state. These are the important parts of the state. So government is not only the element, but also this is very important part for our state. Okay, children, so we will try to end the topic here. We will try to meet you in the next classes. Thank you, children.